I think everyone knows Java and uses Java. And who uses GWT? Okay, and who is developing a rich internet application? Okay, so this is for people who want to develop rich internet application or also in progressive enhancement websites, right? So I think it's with the Cybernet. About me, I am a GWT contributor. I develop libraries like jQuery, also GWT exporter, and GWT upload. Also, I am a Jenkins committer. You know, Jenkins is a continuous integration software, and also I am a member of the Apache community. I am developing a software, it's called James, and it's the the mail server of Apache developed in Java. I think it's Linux, so we have to mirror this place, apply. Okay, keep configuration. It's okay? Great. So, GWT query is a jQuery clone for GWT and much more. About me, I have talked about that. The contents. What is GWT? I'm going to explain briefly what's GWT, what is jQuery, and we are going to learn jQuery. And at the end, I wanted to explain the differences in jQuery applications in the JavaScript size, and also what is JS query. Well, GWT is not a framework, it's not another JavaScript library, it's not a new language, and it's not a web framework. It is a software developed kit, and the main piece of code in the kit is the compiler. We have Java code, and we are going to compile Java to JavaScript code. So we are going to get JavaScript code for each processor, for each browser, like C and C++ does with processors. The advantages of using Java, you know, is it is a high level language, and also if the user uses GWT, he is not going to get lost with low level details like DOM, AJAX, cross domain, obfuscation, etc. There is a huge Java ecosystem, especially we have rich IDEs. We can refactor. We can debug, code assist, etc. We have Maven, we have patterns, builders, TypeSafe, syntax checking. In summary, using Java, large teams are going to reduce errors. And also we can separate the code maintenance from the effectiveness of the executable. And normally the compiler would produce better JavaScript code that we could right by hand. The GWT SDK provide generators, compiler, linker, optimizer, obfuscator, etc. Also, it provides client libraries. Okay, client libraries which are useful for the browser environment. If you use Java in the server side, it provides libraries for the communication if you use RPC or Request Factory. But if you use XML or text or HTML, etc., you don't need anything of GWT in the server side. Even you can replace the server side with any backend. Also, we have a Eclipse plugin, multi-browser dev mode, etc. This is the schema of the developing with GWT. Okay, we start with the Java IDE. You can use Eclipse or whatever, but if you use Eclipse, GWT team maintain the Eclipse plugin. You start coding Java for the client side, and you are in this case the SDK has the compiler, also the emulation of basic libraries in Java, Java util, etc., and many browser libraries for handling XML, for handling the DOM, etc., and a basic set of widgets. Also, you can add third-party client libraries, and the compiler is going to generate the JavaScript and the bundles. Bundles is GWT can generate sprites. I don't know if you know sprites, but basically you can generate for interfaces CSS, image bundles. You can compile a lot of images and put in one file, and it's better to download, etc. So it's and you run this in your browser. Also, GWT provides you with a develop environment, so as you can develop in Java, you can run GWT in Java, and using a plugin in your browser that you can install in Firefox, Explorer, Chrome, etc., you can communicate the browser with the develop mode, and you can debug, you can do almost everything you do with Java. You can stop the code, etc., reload, etc. And also, it gives you an entire test environment. So you can do TDD with GWT. Of course, the browser is going to communicate with any backend using JSON, XML, HTML, or texto. And if you use a Java application server, you can use Request Factory or RPC. And if you are coding in Java, you'd have your Java code, of course, in the same IDE, and this Java code is going to be compiled in Java bytecode. You can add third-party libraries like everything, but GWT provides you with a couple of libraries for RPC and Request Factory. Okay, so this is jQuery. jQuery is a third-party client library. So, what's jQuery? jQuery is a library for GWT, client library, and provides jQuery API and syntax with small differences because of the language. So, Java is different from JavaScript, but we provide almost the same syntax. It has been rewriting entirely in Java, and it's not a wrapper of jQuery implementation, and it's optimized for GWT. It has many features that they are not available in jQuery. We are going to speak about data binding, type safe structures, compile selector, etc. And it's a useful complement for GWT, CSS selector, widget finders, etc. So we can use jQuery as an alternative development way to the normal paradigm in GWT. In GWT, the developing process is to create a desktop-like application using widgets, but you can use jQuery to use the same paradigm that uses jQuery. You can have normal HTML, you can insert normal HTML in the page, and etc. And jQuery is extensible via plugins. It's easy to get in started, so if we copy and paste this code in our terminal, we are going to get a project, the Hello World project, and we will have it available in Eclipse, right? Eclipse is a bit, I don't know what happens with it. And this is the structure of the project, okay? In GWT, you have, it's a Maven project with the sources, the test, the web app. You have a namespace for Java classes that are going to be executed in client side. You have public stuff, HTML, CSS, etc. And you can run the application from the IDE and you can run as web application. I think it was running, okay. So, yeah, it's running. And you can execute it open with Firefox. I was running the application before, so it should work. Run as web application again. Open with Firefox. This is the application. Now the Eclipse is compiling the application. This takes a while, maybe half a minute. And you can see in the IDE the process of compilation here. I think. Yeah, validating new compiling unities. So when you develop in GWT, you normally need the develop mode. So once the develop mode has been started, you have almost everything here. And the application does nothing except that it adds an effect to a division in the DOM. Well, easy to get in started, and IDE friendly. You can use Eclipse, you can, because you are running in a real IDE, you can do refactor, software metrics, code assist, etc. And What is the jQuery object? jQuery object is the same that jQuery object and jQuery object are similar. They both support and return an object. This object represents a collection of DOM elements or XML elements, and the object is has plenty of useful methods. Those methods can be chained, and because the method return the object itself. Okay, this is a basic example. The code is almost equal to the code in jQuery, and this code does. The dollar method is going to return the jQuery object, and it's looking for images with the photo class. It's a CSS selector, and once that we have the object, we can chain almost everything in the collection, like put the source of the photo to the same source, and also we can get the color. So the attribute returns the object itself, but the CSS returns just the value of the CSS attribute. And the size also returns an integer. Okay, so this is the jQuery object, and we have the dollar method. The dollar is legal in JavaScript, and it's also legal in Java. So we use the dollar method in Java, but we cannot use the dollar method for class names, because GWT compiler disallows it. So we use just jQuery as the name of the class. The trick to use the dollar is to include, to import statically the jQuery stuff. Okay, so you can use the dollar in your code, in your Java code, and the dollar method is able to handle different arguments. You can pass a string, and it's going to inspect if the string is a HTML or is a CSS selector. Also, you can pass elements, collection of elements, widgets, and whatever you want. Functions. This is one of the main differences in the syntax between jQuery and jQuery. In jQuery, it's JavaScript, and we use the function, the closure function, to, for instance, for the method each. But in Java, we have to use the inner class function. So the syntax is quite different. We have to create a new function, and also we have to overwrite the f method. It's a convention. You have the name is f, just f, and the f you can overwrite f without arguments, f with element and index, etc. Depending on the method you are going to use with the function. Functions, collection, and grabbing values. So we have seen that jQuery returns a jQuery object. In JavaScript world, you have to declare the return value as a bar, but in Java you have to define which return type it is. You can modify all elements in a collection, or you can iterate and run a function around each element. And some elements, instead of return the collection, returns the appropriate value. Okay, height returns an integer, etc. This is exactly the same that jQuery, collections, and selectors. Both jQuery and jQuery are built around selectors, and both support not only a standard selector, but extra selector like text, password, hidden. They are not CSS standard selector. jQuery uses the Sisel engine. Okay, it's a JavaScript engine which works with any browser, but jQuery has optimized engines writing in Java. Okay, we have writing in Java engines for each browser. We use the more appropriate engine for each browser, and for Explorer, old version of Explorer, we use the Sisel also. And also, a part of that, jQuery has compile time optimizations when using compiled of selector. We are going to see the differences. Okay, in jQuery you have dynamic and compiled selectors. Dynamic selectors are the selector that jQuery uses. So it's dollar string. You can add the context to define or to close the search. For instance, here we can look for node classes inside of this element that is an element with ID whatever, etc. But we also have compiled selector. Compiled selector can be used with immutable selectors. So when you are not going to define the selector at runtime, you can use it, and the performance is quite better. The context is supported, etc. The selector's performance, I think, we have an application here. Okay, this is an application to measure the speed of selectors, okay? So here we are comparing compiled selectors versus dynamic selector in GWT, also the library jQuery, Dojo, and Prototype. There are many other options, but, and if you run this example, you are going to get values where in every cases jQuery beats jQuery, okay? Yeah. This is a comparison with different browsers, different operating systems. And in general, jQuery in compiled mode produces the faster JavaScript code to select DOM elements. And jQuery dynamic selectors are in most cases faster or equal than any other library. The next thing is that jQuery can traverse the DOM. So you get a collection, all divisions with section class. And the next sibling is just the method next, previous with a filter, parent, parents, etc. And additionally, for the GWT world, we can also use widgets. Okay, so we can traverse the DOM to locate widgets, and this is cool because in Java, the only way to have a reference to an instance is injecting it or to having a property anywhere. So you can decouple your code in different pieces, and you can access instance of widget just using selectors. Yeah. We have seen already how to chain methods, and yeah, crazy chaining. In jQuery, sometimes chaining is a bit crazy. The same in jQuery. So here for is an example where you can get the login form. In the login form, you can get the optional label and hide it, and you have to write end to get again the original element, and you can chain forever. Chaining methods, CSS. Well, CSS in jQuery and jQuery is very easy to use. In jQuery, you use key or property key and value. CSS color red, and in jQuery also supports in its syntax a JavaScript object. JavaScript object is a JSON object like this, top, left, etc. And in jQuery you have to put that directly in here, but with jQuery you have to put the symbol $$ that is going to parse the string and produce the property file. Additional, jQuery supports CSS style sheet syntax. I mean, you can put here the value without quotes, and also you can put the semicolon instead of the comma, so as you can copy and paste from a style sheet to your code. And as you know, changing CSS properties, you have to know sometimes the strict syntax. For instance, in background, you have to put first the color, then the URL, then the repeat, scroll, etc. If you put this in different order, most browsers are going to show nothing. Okay, so to avoid that, jQuery provides structures in order that the developer can type safe. So in the case of background, you have the method CSS. When you are writing in your IDE, the IDE is going to suggest which to write here. Okay, so the compiler is going to signal you that you are doing something wrong, and also the IDE is going to suggest which are the options that you can write. Right? If we go to Eclipse, okay, I have background. And it suggests what to write. Okay, so type safing is one of the most powerful things in GWT and also in jQuery. Events. jQuery provides methods for assigning events in across browser way, right? But also GWT provides events for widgets and objects. And jQuery event system that has this the same syntax that jQuery is compatible with GWT. So when we try to add a new event to a widget, we are going to save the original event and we are going to run it again, etc. There are a couple of issues in jQuery and when you are using GWT widgets. If GWT detach a widget, when it is retouched again, jQuery are lost because we cannot control when GWT is detaching and attaching the widget. And also, this is the same, the leaf function. I don't know if you know the leaf function, but in jQuery and jQuery, if you use leaf, you have to be careful with on most events. Leaf is you put leaf in I think in the there is an example here.
Yeah,
here, for instance, you select all anchors in your page, and you put the event live over. So each time that a new object anchor is put in the page, we are going to put in this object the over event. But when you have several elements in the page and you are using most over or most out, etc., you are going to get the performance troubles. So be careful. Here you have a bunch of event examples. Click in all levels, GWT levels, and bin, you can remove the event, etc. And also we have jQuery provides techniques for adding animation and a web page. You can use simple standard animations, fade in, fade out, etc., with just an argument or no argument, providing the timeout or the time to run the animation. But also we have sophisticated custom effect via the animate method. Okay, animate method is a powerful function in jQuery, so we have we support the same syntax. For instance, left plus equal 1000 with the is in swim, etc. I have here for an example. For instance, this is done with jQuery and jQuery. Okay. We support effects also in SVG nodes. I think jQuery doesn't, etc. And something new in jQuery is AJAX support. GWT has facilities for performing communication with the server side, and it provides RPC or request factory for Java backends, and also request builder is to get JSON or to get anything from the server. But jQuery now complements it, adding the jQuery syntax and also builders or data binding builders to handle JSON and XML. The syntax from jQuery that we support is almost everything except get script, because in jQuery get script get a script from the server and then evaluates the JavaScript, and we think that it doesn't it has not so much sense in the GWT world, because you can introduce security issues, etc. So basically the difference in AJAX is that we have to use the jQuery class instead of the dollar, and also the function we have seen that before, and we support get, post, get JSON, etc. And data binding. Okay. Data binding is jQuery already provides the class properties to handle JSON object. We have seen this before. The $$ returns a property, and you can use the, this property to get the key one, etc. And also we can manipulate XML, so you can parse any XML text from the server or from anywhere, and then we can use CSS selector in the element, in the XML element. We have to use, of course, the context, and here the text returning is should be hello, okay? But also jQuery provides generator to produce builders to handle XML and JSON as Java objects. Data binding support getters and setters, and it put a lot of code to check null condition, casting, etc. So it's something magic that happens given a JSON structure like this, where we have keys and values. Some values are numbers, etc. We represent this object with an interface. We call this site. Our site has an ID, has an URL, has a set of tags, and has a referrer. And the ID returns a long, because this is a number, the URL a string, tags a set of strings, and referrer returns again a site, because it is a nested structure. So also we are using here an annotation. Referrer is misspelling in almost every site in internet, so we are going to take care of that, and we are changing the name of the getter and get title. Setters are not displayed because of simplicity. And how do we use that? We use jQuery get JSON. We get the file from the server. Null is because we are not passing any arguments to the post. And we have a new function. So we use GWT create, and GWT create is magic and is going to create the implementation of the interface. So we can use the interface and load the data. The data in functions, you can get the data using this method. And now we use the instance get URL, instance get tags is a collection, an array, sorry, and instance get site, get URL. So this is the alternative. This is using properties, and is more unreadable, because you have to get array, tags, get strings, etc., etc. Okay, this is data binding out of the box, and plugins. Okay, jQuery is extensible through plugins, but we have some Java constraints, because in jQuery, when you develop a plugin, this plugin extends the jQuery object, but in Java we cannot do that. So we use a trick, and the trick is use the method as. We already include some plugins, events, effects, widgets, etc. And we have a site, contributions welcome, and basically we have these plugins ported. And there is a guy that has ported jQuery UI, but it's not an entire port, because it uses the jQuery UI library and is a wrapper for it. But you can use it in jQuery. The usage of the plugins is simple. You use the selector or the method, and you have to put as my plugin, and you have available the new method. The new method in jQuery syntax is in the object. So this is the difference. To develop a plugin, you have to cut and paste this. It's easy. progressive enhancement, you can use jQuery to enhance HTML pages, to enhance widgets, because we are able to manipulate widgets without manipulating the class. It's pretty useful, for instance, to put all button widgets in your interface, something like a new image or whatever. And also, it's compatible with a model view presenter pattern that is widely used in GWT. Okay. The JavaScript size, the application we have here is the Zoom application. This is the application running with jQuery. This is the application compiled with GWT. And if we compare sizes, in the case of GWT, the size is around 70 kilobytes, and it's less than the jQuery minimized library. This is the code that the size of the code that jQuery introduced to the GWT. The rest of the code is GWT, so it's pretty small. And comparing sizes, in this case, the image zoom example needs 17% less of JavaScript code. And if we use deflate in the server, GWT code is pre-ordered and the compression factor is better. So these are the numbers. Okay, and finally, GSquare. What is GSquare? The latest work in jQuery is to produce a clone of the jQuery, which could be used as a replacement of jQuery. We have called that JSquare, and the goal is not to compete against jQuery, but with this approach, we can include jQuery plugins with the need of importing jQuery. And also is a investigation work to demonstrate that we can produce any library, JavaScript library, in Java and export methods. So because jQuery is the most widely used library, we use GWT exporter, etc. This work is not finalized, so we are around 60% of work done, and the main goal is to encourage people to write jQuery plugins, including them as native JavaScript, and create wrappers for the methods. There are some jQuery issues. The main issue is that using GWT exporter, we add an overhead to export that method, and the library in compiling the library with jQuery is not here. I don't. Okay. Anyway, jQuery has 90 kilobytes, and no, this not. Sorry. Yeah, it's 90 kilobytes, and we have 140 kilobytes. So, but in compressed mode, the difference is not so much. And also, you will let exported spend time, etc. This is an example of jQuery. If we go here, also a part of the Zoom example, we have here the Zoom example running with. Okay, it works also. And the main difference is you have your application and you have to replace the jQuery library with our API library. This is a set of links. If you want to, for instance, plugins, this is plugins from the, okay, this is GWT query UI. I think you can see the source here, the HTML source, and you can see how write less, do more paradigm and links. Conclusions, people knowing jQuery can easily use jQuery because we share the API. jQuery uses Java, so there are many advantages of using Java, especially for large teams, TypeSafe, etc. jQuery uses GWT, so don't worry about compression, obfuscation, etc. And you can develop using TDD, many libraries available, and it complements the GWT world, helps to develop application using the jQuery paradigm instead of the GWT. It's mature, and we have just released today 1.1.0 version, and the plugin system is simple, and we are looking for contributors. So the announcement for today is that we have just released 1.1.0 released today with all of these features, and we wanted to match the new release with the Riviera Dev event. And this, I think, is almost everything. I wanted to show you where I am working now. I am doing this application, and this application is being developed with jQuery and GWT, of course. This application is an application for seeing photos and posting, and you can navigate using the wheel. Now we are going to introduce 3D management of the wheel, and yeah, this is all. If you have any question. Yeah. Okay, I want to encourage you to participate with the project, not only the jQuery, but also there are many projects around the world that are waiting for contributors. So Apache, GWT, etc.